AI is a buzzword now. Everyone is talking about it. But how can AI help us photographers? Seven things that I think are the best ones. Hi, it's Peter here, and let's get right into the business. Before we get into those seven things, we have to remember that the use of AI is something that you should be in control of and not let the AI rule the things. There's a saying that goes, the tool should not rule the man. At its best, it's a good help, but it's not a great master. So you have to be in control and not let AI do everything. It can help us a lot, and we will start with the first one. The first one is subject recognition AI. I believe the first camera that had AI-based subject recognition was EM1X that was launched in January 2019. It was a bit of a revolutionary thing at the time because, as I said, I believe it was the first real big camera that had that feature. I remember that people were slightly mocking, yeah, you know, recognizing trains is not a big thing and all that, but it was the first one. And of course, when you have the first evolution, it might not be at its best, even though it worked very well on the subject that it had. And now that feature is a standard feature in almost all the flagship cameras that different manufacturers make. So that is one of the biggest things. For example, bird recognition makes photographing birds in flight very easy. But remember, you still have to pressing the shutter at the right time so that you can really nail the shot. But you don't have to worry about the AF. AI will take care of that. And the same goes with portraiture, for example. You don't have to, you know, concentrate on the AF. You can concentrate on the model itself. And the second thing is computational photography. It gives us so many new possibilities to make great images. Of course, it cannot make the images for us, but it can help a lot, like multiple exposure, live ND, focus stacking, pixel shift. All that is kind of based on AI, even though you could argue that it's not AI. But anyways, computational photography is something that makes us have more possibilities to make great images. And then there is bokeh and shallow depth of field effect. You know that, for example, smartphones are struggling with getting, you know, shallow depth of field, but it can be done in computational ways. And that is also something that has come into certain cameras. I think Sony has a few vlogging cameras that has the feature that will blur the background, and it even will make the skin tones look better. I think the newest vlogging camera, I think it was V10 from Canon, has that feature, and it can be a bit overdone, but when used correctly, I think it is one of the best features in computational photography too, because having slightly out of focus background is a lot better. You can get the separation from the background easier, and the focus and the sharpness will be on the subject. And if it can be done in computational ways, I think it's a progress, even though we have to remember that it doesn't look exactly the same as when it's done optically with a lens and a wide aperture. But still, I think it's a good thing if used wisely. And then there are a lot of things about image editing where I think at the moment has been the biggest progress in AI. And the first one is upscaling the images. Softwares like Gigapixel AI, Photo AI from Topaz Labs are good examples. What I think is that when those get even better, they are quite good already, but when they get even better, it will make the pixel amount obsolete to a certain point. We don't need 40 megapixels, 20 megapixels is enough. We can upscale it and you don't see the difference. And I think that's the biggest thing on that. And of course, if you have 40 megapixels and you need 120, you can upscale the image and it looks totally fine. So making high megapixel images with upscale and photo AI, I think is a good way, and it will make high megapixel cameras obsolete in certain extent, of course. And also, for example, like photo AI can enhance your image so that it will look a lot better than the original. And also DxO Mark's Photo Lab 6 with its optic modules and everything can make a little bad-looking image a lot better. And what I mean is technically, of course, it won't fix your bad composition or all that, but it will make the image look better. So wisely used gigapixel and photo AI and DXO's software is a good thing. It can help a lot. And then there is noise reduction AI, which I think is one of the best things in image editing for a long, long time, because of course, sometimes you use high ISO in your camera and you get a lot of noise. But with the noise reduction softwares like Topaz Denoise, DXO Pure Raw's Deep Prime, which is included in DXO Pure Raw and also in Photolab 6. And then now the newest kid on the block is Lightroom when it comes to noise reduction. It has an excellent noise reduction algorithm, and they all using AI. They use the so-called neural network and deep learning to know how the noise works and still can keep the details, which is of course important. But I think that will also make high ISO photography a lot easier when you can almost get a clean image after you used the noise AI from different software. Which one is the best? It depends on the image. I've done several tests about it. You probably noticed that I recorded this in a different taste because I just realized I have a different glasses on because I was editing and realized that this part was missing. But here it is. Let's go to the next one. And then we have automated image editing, which is of course something that is not advised to do quite a bit. But with Skylum's Luminar Neo, for example, retouching a portrait, it goes so fast and smoothly. And I use it quite a lot for portraits because I can make some presets and just click that and I can adjust hundreds and thousands of images in a very, very fast way. And also Lightroom's new Masks AI, which automatically detects different parts of human being, for example, and you can edit them separately. I think that's also a really, really good way of making your image editing faster. But remember, you have to do the editing part yourself, but the mask separation or choosing the masks and making the masks should be led to AI. It's a lot faster and in sometimes it's even better. So that's, I think, is one of the best things that you can do with AI in image editing, are the automated AI masks. And after the seventh tip, I will have an extra tip like always. And then one big thing is automated cataloging images, making databases of your images with certain different parameters. And I use Xire Search and Xire Photo for that. It can detect the images by keywords, similar images, colors, whatnot. And that is a very fast way of finding your images because writing the keywords to every image is something, for example, I've not done that much. So finding my images from Lightroom catalog is not that easy. But with Xire Search, I can do it very fast and very efficient. It's not perfect yet, but it's getting better and better. And I use it quite a lot when I search images for my videos because it's just so much faster than just browsing through images and trying to guess where they are. But here we can use AI to find those images. Then the extra thing, text-based image generators. This is probably the biggest and, to be honest, the scariest part of AI in image making, because it will, I mean, the AI images that are generated by text only will wipe out a lot of work from photographers, and I mean professional photographers. It doesn't really affect the hobby photographers or the amateur photographer who is not making a living out of photography, because of course going out and photograph is a lot better thing than just writing text and or prompts and then get an image out. But for example, stock photography will be vanished, that's for sure, because it's a lot faster, a lot easier to make the image writing text and let the AI generate the image because the quality is astonishing. It's only like a little over half a year that DALL-E was released to general public so anybody could use it, and now the progress in the quality of the images is huge. It's gone so much. So what will happen after 5 years? It's going to be crazy. And it's also a bit scary because you can make almost anything. And that is the scariest thing that has happened to professional photographers in my career, because that is the first thing that photographers' job are really on the line. Of course, there've been disruptions before, but not this big. This is going to be huge. Will AI make photographers obsolete? I don't think so. We still need photographers, and of course amateur photography won't be affected that much by by all this. It will help you if you use it wisely. But what it does, it will replace photographers who do not use AI. That's for sure, because AI makes everything so more efficient and faster when used correctly. And here is the video about my thoughts about AI and image creation with text-based image creators. But hey, thanks for watching and bye for now.